Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my NBA 2K17 My GM expansion team series with the Seattle Sports Gaming Universe. Now, we've spent two episodes getting operations off the ground, forming this team from the ground up, everything from arena creation to logos to team uniforms, getting the draft lottery done, getting the NBA draft and the expansion draft done. All that's led up here to game number one.
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. We'll see the Golden State Warriors facing Seattle.
So here we are, tipping off a brand new NBA franchise, one of two in the league this year. Obviously, you got the Kansas City Knights as well coming in with the Seattle SGU, but we are underway, and I mistakenly said we were going to be taking on the defending champion Golden State Warriors. No, that's not true. They lost to LeBron and the Cavs in the finals, so they've got something to prove after that record regular season last year. They're back. Now, this version does not have Kevin Durant. As you see, our number one draft pick, Chris Dunn, nailing a three to start his career. Yeah, you know who specializes in threes? The Splash Brothers. That's Klay Thompson. And here comes Steph Curry with a floater off the backboard, as he likes to do when he drives. What I was about to say is this version of the Warriors does not have Kevin Durant. He decided to go to Atlanta in free agency. What this team does have that's different, they have Pau Gasol. So not only was the 2016 NBA draft rewritten in the version that we're playing here, but the free agency period as well. You got those free agents going to different teams. As you see, Timothy Mozgov getting a basket, and he'll have a chance for an N1 opportunity as we start pretty hot here, out to a 10-5 lead against the Warriors. But look out, because they can light it up from anywhere. Steph Curry looking for an open shot. He is going to take it right there and make it. Mid-range shot, and it's 10-9. Golden State actually takes the lead, 11-10 now. Mozgov calling for the ball down on the block. He's going to lose the handle, but then he kicks it back out to Chris Dunn, who knocks down the three. He's got two of those early on. Timeout, Golden State. And there you go, SGU pushing the pace so far.
Hey, if we let up on D even a little, it's enough to get their guy going.
I would say their guy's going. Both Klay and Steph Curry will shoot it from anywhere, so we definitely have to be careful on defense. Sometimes that's not enough because they have such range. Even playing good D is not always going to get it done. So we're moving this around the perimeter. There's Fournier with the fake, and then he's got the wide open lane to the dunk. Can I just say how sweet the replay packages look when they flash my logo up there? It looks so awesome. Oh, man, I love all the customization and integration into this mode. From the court to the uniforms to, well, that's Klay Thompson knocking that down from huge distance. Drive right there in a bucket. Count it. And a chance for a three-point play. Again, there's my graphic wipe. I love it. It looks great, doesn't it? Okay, so there's the bucket. That is Shelvin Mack making that, coming off the bench. And we are trying to work this around. They're going to kick it back out for three, and once again knock one down. It's 26-20. First quarter almost over. Mack's going to kick that out, and Fournier knocks it down from three. 29-22 at the end of the first quarter. All right, I like what we're seeing here from our expansion club so far. Let's keep it up. Trying to drive, that's not going to work. The pass underneath to Mozgov, that is going to get him a bucket. 31-22. The offense is clicking right now. And what can we do? Oh, almost tipped it away from Curry. You know what? He doesn't care. Look at the arc on that three. Smooth as butter. And, you know, I have to say, I only play on low difficulties, like pro or something like that. Yeah, Steph Curry is a beast on pro. I'd hate to see what he's like on the highest settings. Anyway, they've done a very good job. I felt like last year they didn't represent him nearly well enough, and oh yeah, he just does not miss open looks like this, and he shoots from ranges you'd see him in real life. We always talked about him basically being a video game out there in the real life NBA court, and well, now the video game's caught up to him a bit. It's nice to see that they've got a much more lifelike Steph Curry this year, but it does make things difficult. Hey, Chris Dunn says, I can knock down threes. He's hit three of them here in this first half. It's a 39-28 lead. hey, maybe we can go out and complete that owner goal of winning our home opener. We knew it was going to be tough against the Warriors, and they're going to keep hitting their shots. That's a three that's going to miss, but look at the tip back by Mozgov. Man, what a pickup he was. Free agency wire after the free agency period, signed for the minimum, but he comes right in here and starts on this expansion club and already making his mark, trying to get down low, not going to work, finds Chris Dunn, and he not only misses the shot, but Chris Dunn, slow to get up. Here come the Warriors the other way, and it's going to be a three ball from Curry. Oh, he finally misses. Rebound and timeout. We've got a big issue here, folks. That's our number one draft pick, Chris Dunn, being helped up to his feet and off the court. And obviously we're fearing the worst here, but hoping that he can shake off whatever that was and be okay to return to this game. Kind of a hushed silence over this crowd for a minute as they see Chris Dunn go down in a heap. He was having such a nice start to his first ever NBA game. Golden State pushing things here at halftime a little bit. They've gotten it to 50-43, so they're down 7. We've got to be happy outside of the injury with our performance in the first half. Let's see if we can continue putting the pressure on Golden State. That's going to be Michael Beasley, another value free agent signing, doing some work for us and pitching in.
A chance here to get a quick injury report. Let's check in with David Aldridge for an injury update on Chris Dunn. David.
Hi, guys. The head athletic trainer for Seattle let me know the status. Unfortunately, he's saying it appears to be a broken ankle, which, if it's true, could be devastating. He won't return to this game, and he could be looking at a very long recovery process.
Oh, brother. Well, you heard it from David Aldridge first. They are thinking it's a broken ankle for Chris Dunn, and that is going to put this team in a very bad spot if true.
Love the energy, fellas. I really do. But now we got to keep it up and stay focused. Now let's stay sharp and finish strong.
Okay, you hear the directions from the timeout at the bench right here, and we continue on third quarter play. We continue with the lead. This has been a great game so far, but you can't sleep on these guys. Easy basket down low, and Andrew Bogut is the recipient of the pass right there as we're trying to get to the basket. Yeah, they're not going to let us. Oh, but with the shot clock winding down, he does find a way to get in there and get the layup. 66-60. This is getting tight here. Try to double team Steph Curry. Not a bad idea, except when they pass out of it. And there's Livingston with the easy jam. So, I don't know. Take the ball out of Curry's hands. They're very capable in other places. Three ball. Going to extend the lead to 69-62. We're into the fourth quarter now. 71-64. Let's try to D up. Well, it's not happening there. Curry wide open for a layup, and they're continuing to make their comeback. We got to hold them off here. Harrison Barnes looking for a screen. There's nowhere to go, but look at the nifty move. He maneuvers through there and finds himself a layup. Very much contested, but he's able to get it to go. 73-68 now. Okay, get this ball to Mozgov. Mozgov down low. Nope, that pass is picked off. And here come the Warriors the other way. Iguodala with the jam. He'll find himself on the Kia Slam Cam for his efforts. Three-point game. Okay, keep the composure here. We don't have Chris Dunn, but we have Harrison Barnes with the slam with some emphasis right there. Back up to a five-point lead. Barnes. Going to kick this out for three. Michael Beasley comes up with the three ball. 78-70. Okay, keep pushing here. We got a little more than half of the quarter left. And that is going to be a bucket. A three ball as he stepped back. Steph Curry, of course, right? You knew that was coming. 80-75 now. Look at Mozgov from the free throw line. He's knocking it down. A very solid game for Mozgov at the center position. 84-75. Oh, really? You're going to leave him that wide open for a look? Okay, three-pointer. And we're stretching that lead back a little bit. 4:24 to play. Klay Thompson. Money. Yep. Don't want to leave him wide open ever. But that's exactly what they did. Final seconds ticking down. We got the 10-point lead. We're actually going to do this. Get the ball to Mozgov one more time. He's going to shoot, and he knocks it down. Great game for Mozgov. Great game for Seattle. as the sports gaming universe get their first ever NBA win, and what a big one it is, coming against Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, and the Golden State Warriors. So how about that? A team that won 73 games last year in the regular season are now 0-1 to start this season. Time to find out who the player of the game was.
As we present our Jordan player of the game, Timofey Mozgov.
So like I said, Mozgov had a solid game. I think Chris Dunn might have been on his way to being player of the game had he not gotten injured, and we need to find out what's up with that after the game. But Mozgov has a monster game at the center position and helps us to this first ever franchise win. And wow, this was a great effort all around. Lots of guys pitching in, but Mozgov named your player of the game, and rightfully so. So now we've completed that goal, getting that first home game won. I wasn't so sure about it. I answered kind of in the middle. We'll try. Oh, and here we go. Here is the news on Chris Dunn. Trainer Scott O'Gallagher confirms it's a broken ankle. 4 to 6 weeks is the prognosis here. So we're going to just go ahead and let Coach Billy Donovan go ahead and do what he wants to do with the rotation here to fix things. And you'll get some trust for both the trainer and your head coach by making that decision. So the right decision in my mind. Now we got a press conference and talking about the direction of this franchise. What will Leroy Mack talk about? Where is his focus with this franchise? Build a dynasty or consistently improve or wait and see? Now we're going to be bold. We're going to say that we are trying to build the dynasty here because what? You know, why not? Build this thing from the ground up and build it into a perennial winner. So that's how he's going to answer. And we'll have to see what kind of impact that has with the franchise and with the media. It nudged our trust down a little bit with our owner. It got the players and the opposing GMs bumped up a little bit. So kind of a mixed reaction. So when we come back, we are going to play our expansion brethren, the Kansas City Knights. It'll be our first road game. We get to check out what's going on with that franchise. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place.